Hey guys, if you haven't heard about Anchor, it's the easiest way to make a podcast with everything you need all in one place. Let me explain. Anchor has the tools that allow you to record and edit your podcast right from your phone or computer. When hosting on Anchor, you can distribute your podcast on listening platforms like Spotify, Apple Podcasts, and more. And trust me guys, it works. It's everything you need to make a podcast all in one place. And the best of all, it is totally free. Yes, totally free. So download the Anchor app today or go to anchor.fm to get started. Good morning, everybody. It's actually a cloudy Monday. I don't know why, but you know, just like normal, every morning, gotta start with yourself a nice glass of coffee. Always hits a spot in the morning. But how's everyone doing today? How was everyone's week? How was everyone's weekend? That's always the fun part to know. My week is starting to pick up. You know, it's not slow like it was. Taking my unit 10 exam for my class. And because then once I'm done with after that, then I need to do the full exam for the Nebraska law. And then I'll be moving on with my real estate classes. Which is good. Because after that, I just need one more class. And then I'd be done. The only thing I'd have would be my exam prep. But I'm still waiting on the state to shoot me an email and say, hey, you know, your background check came back. And you can finally schedule an exam date. Because, you know, everyone needs that. Oh, excuse me. Kind of just burped. But, oh, it's been all day. Not all day. Well, my bad. The day just started. Shit, all week. It's been pretty hot. It's actually been hitting in the high 90s to low 100s. I don't know about you, but I'm supposed to be sweating. That car gets hot because the AC doesn't work. So the only thing that it does is just blow hot air. And God, I hated that. But, I mean, what can I do? I mean, I could get it fixed, but I don't have that money to be taking it to a mechanic shop and then them, you know, fix it for a nice hefty price. And no, that's why the podcast is called Broke Boy Podcast. Oh, and by the way, welcome back to the Broke Boy Podcast. I'm your host, Marco. Now let's get back to what I was talking about. You know, just bullshit morning, you know. But yeah, I mean, today's going to be, hopefully, an easy day. Only got about, let's see, I went to bed around 5-ish, not 5-ish, 1-ish. So I got about, maybe close to 6 hours asleep. Not intentional, though, because I was going to record the podcast episode yesterday and have it uploaded this morning, but I was taking my exam, my unit, my quiz, I guess you can say, and I was just too tired. It was past midnight. I just wanted to go to bed. And so I said, fuck it, I'll do it this morning. Earlier. But anywho, my girlfriend, she's still currently sleeping right now. She is snoring her balls off because she's had a long week. And I'm super proud of her for that. And she's gotten great news at work. But I can't expose that yet, not until it's been 100% true. So, yeah. I'm hoping, because since I already have the adapter for the MacBook, I'm hoping to get a USB like output, but it has like 4 USB things out, and then hopefully to get another mic. So then I can start asking around people that at my work if they want to be on a podcast. You know, it doesn't get much listens. It gets about average 3-4 per episode, but hope one day people start sharing and it gets more. And I truly do appreciate everyone that decides to listen. And same with the Facebook page. I got a notification not too long ago. That first it was at 15 likes, and then when I looked again, it was at 20 likes, which I'm super appreciative of you guys. I love you guys for that. Thank you very much for that. And then on my Instagram, I think I have about like maybe 10 followers, maybe. Let me double check. Oh no, I actually have 29. Oh, that's actually good. Damn, sheesh. I didn't even know that. Oh, well, even better. So thank you for all those followers. Some of those followers aren't people that I know. I mean, some of them are, I'm assuming bots. And because some of them were like Middle Eastern people that I've never known. Some are just some trashy Fortnite kids and whatever, so. But I was able to get milk. Fuck. That milk was nice and cold. I haven't drank it yet. My girlfriend told me to get it. But I closed one day. I closed that on the day that she told me to get milk. They closed the registers. And because technically, they could have kept them open for the closing associates that need to get stuff and for the overnight crew. But they were like changing the papers, changing like the bills and doing all this. They were taking forever, and then they just continued to just close it immediately. Because I'm assuming, because when the store closes like exactly at 10, that's when the overnight crew comes in. And so I'm assuming that the overnight crew weren't gonna go get some stuff since it's already 10. So I was like, well, gotta get the next day. I decided to head over to Super Saver, and it's expensive there because average milk prices from Target and Walmart, the two competitors here, they were $2.39 for a gallon. $2.39 a gallon. Like, slap my pussy, but $2.39, that's really good. And at Super Saver, they were about $4.60. Either $4.30 or $4.60 a gallon. Hell, the vitamin D one, the whole milk, I guess you can call it, was the only one on sale for $2.39. That was the only one on sale. And I don't know about you, I don't really care what milk I drink. But my girlfriend, she's picky. She likes the 2%. Only the 2%. Because, let's just say she didn't have a great experience at one of her aunt's house. When she had to try skim milk for the first time. Or I like to call it milk water. And yeah, she did not like that at all. And it's very expensive. But talking about expensive, gas prices, they were at an all-time high here. The cheapest gas you could find in Lincoln if it wasn't $4.89, I believe it was like $4.95, was the cheapest. Hell, even I believe Sam's Club was reaching like $4.90. Like $4.85, $4.89, $4.90 in that range. That was the cheapest gas. Now they're starting to bring it down, which I'm so thankful for. Cause goddamn, I hate paying like $65 to $70 every time I fill. And I don't have like a hybrid car. I don't have a fuel efficient car, so that makes it worse. Sorry. I had to take a sip of my coffee.
That makes it worse when it's not fuel efficient.
And now, the expensive gas is like the Casey's, Route 66. Not Route 66. Whatever the fuck that gas station's called.
Shell, like the expensive ones, Valero, they're now down to 419. I haven't checked Sam's Club yet, but 419, that's really good. Because since I have T-Mobile, and up until I believe it's like the beginning or the end of September, they to like the fuel reward places. So I believe here it's like Hy-Vee and Shell. They give me 25 cents off a gallon, and so when I let my girlfriend use it, she believe saved like 3 4 bucks, which isn't a lot, but when you think about it, that's almost a whole extra gallon of gas. That's not really good. And now it being 4.19, I'm sorry, but I mean, don't mind me if I have to use gas again. But I haven't checked Sam's Club. I hope to God Sam's Club is like below $4. Because if so, I'm gonna cream. But yeah, it's for how I was looking outside. So it's gonna rain. But groceries are starting to get expensive now that we're still on the topic of it being expensive. Chicken, like the chicken breast, the skinless, boneless chicken breast that I used to buy at Walmart, like a pack of, I think it's like six, seven. A average was like anywhere from $9 to $12, just depending on how heavy the package was. Now, average is starting to be like 10, 10.50 to like $15. I'm like, good lord, for the same chicken? Like, what the fuck? And some items that I see at Target and Walmart, and sometimes Hy-Vee, and they're like, oh, this box of mac and cheese is on sale for like $1 or for like 90 cents. And it's like the name, it's the store brand. And I'm like, oh, you're telling me the store brand mac and cheese is on sale for the price that I used to usually pay for? Like, that's ridiculous. Hell, candy is starting to get expensive. And I don't really eat candy a lot on the ba like on a daily basis, but sometimes I might just crave me some Skittles, a Snickers bar, whatever. And when I saw fucking at Hy-Vee, Starburst were on sale for 99 cents, and they were usually at like $1.50. I'm like, ah, that's ridiculous. Who the hell is gonna spend $1.50 on Skittles when they were normally a dollar, like 99 cents? Like, the fuck, my ninja? Like, the fuck? I don't know. I just hope prices are going down, like with the whole housing market. Like, some are starting to go up, some are starting to go down, but as the prices go down, the interest rates go up. And well, I'm not a licensed realtor yet. I'm not a licensed agent yet, so I can't really. I mean, I could dabble my fingers in real estate. They talk about real estate, but everything I'm gonna see is gonna be on the media, and sometimes the media always likes to over-exaggerate shit. So, and by the way, we're not in a 2008 recession. Just a heads up, we're not. But my cousin's wedding is happening soon. I wish I could go, but I don't know if maybe they just sent the invites late or I just got the invite late. Because the lettering, like the envelope was a little bit, not smashed, but like a little bit, it looks like a little bit beaten up. So I don't know if maybe it was just passed around too much or whatever. But they did it like almost the, I think close to the end of July. And they, I think she sent me the message like almost at the beginning of the year, almost like maybe March or May. And so if I was able to get the invite earlier, then I would have planned to go, but because they didn't, I'm like, well, I might just send him a gift. Well, I wish I could go, but I might just send him a gift because I'm gonna have to be working. But like, I'm gonna with one of my friends, he's getting married, and he did invite us way earlier in advance. To the point where I'll be able to go to his. Well, I believe it's like September. I think like September 5th or 4th. Like the beginning of September. One, around there. Yeah, happy to see him get married. Yeah, shout out to Gilberto Rodriguez. I know he doesn't listen to it. And like the three or four of you that are listening probably don't know who he is. But say, he's a great guy. Smart guy too. Very smart guy. I'm proud of him, and can't wait to see what food he's gonna have. Cause, sometimes the food at the Mexican weddings are amazing. It's probably why I gained so much fucking weight up in Mexico. Because the shit in Mexico, oh my god. I haven't been there in a bit, but when I was, oh, that was amazing. Like all the street tacos, like the actual true Mexican street tacos. Oh, those were amazing. Those aren't like the Mexican street tacos that you get like Taco John's. Like, who the fuck gets street tacos from Taco John's? Like what the fuck? Like, do you moan when you wipe your ass? Like, what the hell is that? It just hits different. Let me just tell you that. It's different. I mean, I guess to get the full experience of what I'm talking about, I guess you could go to, like, the southern states, like Albuquerque, California. Not Albuquerque, I'm fucking dumb. New Mexico, California. Texas would be a big one. And get, like, the Mexican, the street tacos there. You'll get, like, a true Mexican experience. A true taco experience. But yeah, I mean, that's my story of me being hungry, being fat. My girlfriend, she's not up yet. She set an alarm for 11 a.m. just to her to be positive enough that she'll wake up around then. And because, you know, she wants to get breakfast around that time, when by then lunch is starting. But who am I to judge? Because I would go get breakfast or make some simple breakfast at home, but sometimes I'll just starve myself. Yeah, I'm used to it when I have to go to work early in the morning, and I'll just get a snack at work. Talking about work, I got in trouble. Got pulled into the office because they didn't know where I was at for like. He over-exaggerated it. He said for almost two hours. I told him, well, that's bullshit because I know what time I clocked out, which was like around 7-11. And I stopped taking orders, like pickup orders around like 7-ish. Because I wasn't gonna go ahead and do an order and then take around like 20-ish, 30 minutes, go bag it, and then put it away. When, you know, I knew what time I wanted to take my lunch, and you know, for, so, when I got done around 7, I decided to go to the bathroom, because I had to go, and so, you know, come back, get out, I mean, I went to clock out for lunch, I had to go eat some lunch, and what I usually do is, I always like to take my break the latest I could. Than I can, because to me, if I do like what they always do, the 2-2-2 of 2 hours, 15, other 2 hours, your lunch, another 2 hours, your last break. I don't like that, so I'll do 3 hours, my first break, about, because I can't take it later than 6, so I'll do about like 2 hours and 55 minutes later, I'll take my lunch, and then after my lunch, I'll take my last break. Why? Because I don't want to take my lunch the latest that I can and then work for like an hour
and then take my last break and then only have like 40-ish minutes left. I'd rather do my lunch and then clock in, take my break, so it'd be about like 45, and then I'd still have a good like 2-ish hours to be doing stuff. And then that way I feel more productive than doing that. And I guess I can't get mad at him for him not knowing about it, about what I do. And when I got pulled into the office and I explained that to him, he wasn't mad. He understood it. That's good that you prefer to be taking your breaks late. And I'm like, oh, that's perfect. He understands. But took my lunch. But I guess, you know, if I told him in advance, I guess I wouldn't have been much in trouble. But when I did take my lunch, like I said, clocked in, and then went back to break. And let's just say we were at Runza, eating, you know, just chatting, having a good time. And, you know, just a coworker that I don't really work with much. I've seen him here and there, but I don't really work with him. Was there, and I told my girlfriend, I'm like, hey, look, I don't know that guy personally. I actually don't even know his name, but you know, I'll sometimes work with him. I'll sometimes see him here and there helping out, doing some pickup orders or whatever, you know, just sometimes. But I think it was just busy, like really busy in there, and there weren't much people. And so, I guess you can say he kind of snitched on me, because my team lead was trying to find me. He was like, you know, where is this guy? And the other guy, and the one that I told you about in Runza, he was there. And you know, obviously him being there, he told him that, hey, you know, I saw him at Runza around this time. And he's been there for a bit. And like I said, I was just going to take my 15, grab my stuff, walk back, and start working. However, I got caught up in talking with my girlfriend about my podcast, just on ways maybe I can improve it or whatever, about my real estate and YouTube and whatnot. And you know, I just completely forgot. I just got lost in the zone. I just completely forgot. And you know, he was graceful enough and kind enough to say, you know, I'm glad that I was able to own up to my own mistake. Because, you know, it took like 30 minutes, so I was gone for about an hour. And I explained to him, like, I told him, like, we were talking, and then I said, look at the time, and I realized, oh, shoot, it's already 8:15. I gotta go back. He wasn't really, yes, he was a little bit mad, but he wasn't, like, pissed mad. He was just kind of wondering, I guess he could just say he was more frustrated because of how super busy it was, and he didn't know where I was at, and so he was just wondering, you know, like, what happened, like, where did you go? And so I explained, and that was that. And so he just told me, hey, from now on the walkie, say, hey team, I'm going to my 15, or hey team, I'm going to my 30 minute. And usually I don't say it because, you know, there's just so much people there that, I mean, like during the day, when I go on my break, no one really cares. I go to my lunch, no one cares. Yeah, maybe I'll tell him if I see him, but I don't know. I guess you could say just an insecurity of me going up on the walkie and saying, hey team, I'm going to my lunch, because I don't really want to like announce to the world that I'm going on my lunch, but I guess at the same time, I kind of have to now. But he's a great guy, though. Great guy. And I had to help this one lady. Well, that same day, too, I had to help this one lady who spoke hardly any English. And, you know, I could speak Spanish. I could speak, like, a good amount of Spanish. And so I thought, you know, so if she was just needing help in Spanish, I'd be able to, you know, help her. The problem, it wasn't Spanish. believe it was like Vietnamese or Chinese, Japanese, whatever. It's just Asian. Oh, I can't just say Asian. That's saying it's a little bit racist. But of people around that side of the world, she spoke hardly any English, and I didn't know what she wanted. And let's just say she got a little bit frustrated. Oh, my bad. I'm a little bit frustrated. I'm like, I'm sorry. I don't know what you're wanting. I'm sorry. I wish I could help, but I don't know what you want. And I kind of feel bad. But at the same time, I mean, what the hell does she want me to do? Read her fucking mind? Or be racist and go ching chong bong bong? Like, fuck no. I'm not that type of person. I'm not gonna be rude. But it's almost now moving on from that. I'm looking at the date and wow, it's already July 25th. 3 weeks ago was the 4th of July. It doesn't even feel like that long. We're already past halfway of the year. We're already past that. I'm like, holy shit. How are we already past that? I feel like I haven't done shit. I mean, I'm almost done with the real estate. My real estate classes, and you know, I hope to be starting that anytime soon, but oh my gosh. Soon enough, it's gonna be 2023. I'm gonna be 22 fucking years old. Oh my god. Sign me up for AARP, because I'm getting fucking old. Holy shit. Sign me up for adult diapers, because oh my god. Time's going by fast. I just spent all summer working, and I just hope, I just pray. If it wasn't this summer, hopefully during maybe fall time. Winter, possibly, but maybe springtime-ish. Springtime, summertime of next year is when I can truly go to a vacation. When I can truly take my girlfriend on a vacation, and we can go ahead and go. And, you know, because she wants, on her birthday, she wants to go to Greece. I don't know if she's changing her mind, but as far as I know, she wants to go to Greece. And for my birthday, I want to go to Dubai. And I know it's a lot of money to be spending, especially since it's overseas. But I just hope I'm able to fulfill that promise. Hopefully, I'm able to kick it off really well in real estate and to keep working. So then, not only I could be saving my money, be able to accomplish that, because I want to go to Dubai, the city of the riches. I want to go to Greece, like, oh, no. But at the same time, because of the time, I mean, Greece would probably be fine, because her birthday's around April, but mine's in February, and so I don't know if I want to risk it going to Dubai when it's, like, cold time. Maybe I could go to Dubai during the summer, because I do want to be doing, I want to ride a hot air balloon. I want to go to the Museum of the Future, I think is what it's called. I want to see the Burj Khalifa. I want to see the Burj Al Arab. I want to be doing a bunch of shit. And so I'm thinking of leaning it off to more of the summer. Just sticking it more to the summer. And just so if it's hot enough to be going to, like, the desert and riding a camel, doing all this, and not going to it during when it's cold. So that's my plans for my vacationing. And so again, I just hope I do really well. It goes really well. And like I said, you know, hopefully, if I pass my exam, I know I will. I'm determined to pass my exam, my real estate exam.
Again, it's still in my mind to like the three or four people that are listening. Well, I'm possibly thinking of doing like a business shower. I'll recap of what it is. A business shower. Think of it as like a baby shower where, you know, there's like maybe like some snacks and, you know, depending, maybe some food, just depending on what we still plan on thinking of doing. And I'll just bring office gifts. Just like, you know, invite people that, and just see who all comes, and, you know, just have a great time. Just chat. You can bring gifts if you want. You don't need to. If you want to, you know, even just bring cards that just say congratulations. It'll mean a lot to me. And like I said, it's think of it like a baby shower, but it's not. It's a more of a business shower. And so, you know, you could ask, oh, hey, you know, where are you going? You know, what's it? Think of it, it's like a graduation type of thing, but I'm not graduating from college. I'm getting a real estate license. And so, you know, I'm still thinking about doing it, but if I do, I might just send out Facebook links, like the Facebook invites, compared to physical cards. Because that'd be way too much fucking money. So I might just do Facebook, the Facebook invite, and plus by doing that, I would know around how much people would be interested, either would be going or would be interested in going. And so, if, let's say if I do decide to run out of space in like a Chinese buffet restaurant or someplace like a pizza place or whatever, right there we could. For like the 2 hours or whatever that it's there, you know, pizza could be there, or go get some Chinese food or something or whatever. And even if it's not a lot of people, if it's maybe just like my family that comes, or like Trini's families, or both, if only they come, like her parent, or like her mom or whatever, her mom and her sister and her cousin and my family, maybe my brother, even that, I mean, it'd be some food. But, you know, if I do decide to do it and some people aren't able to, you know, and I send out the Facebook invites, you know, if you, I'll put the address there if you ever wanted to send some cards or just send me a message. It'll mean a lot to me. But, anywho, it's time for me to go take my Unit 10 exam for my class. Take one more sip of this coffee. Now that hits the spot. Anyways, I hope you guys like listening to this. It's not interesting. Again, I'm hoping to be able to get that adapter to get another mic, and then hopefully have another guest, just so you guys don't have to hear me talk anymore to myself, I guess you can say. And try to find someone. Try to find a guest who would be interested in listening and being in a podcast and just talk about their life. But again, thank you for tuning in to the Broke Boy Podcast. Really appreciate and love you guys. And I hope you guys have a great rest of your morning. Peace.